Hello, I'm native Russian and I'm gonna record my Russian accent because maybe some of you need it for your university work or something like that. Like my friend in America, she asked me to record my voice and I decided to record my voice for everyone who will need it. So I will read some parts from the book The Princess and the Pea, and I will speak relaxed without trying to show Russian accent, like hello, I'm Russian and I'm very strong. I will speak relaxed, just how I talk to foreigners, you know. And so we start. That night during a terrible thunderstorm, there was a knock at the door. A servant went to go answer the door, and a young woman stood outside, dressed in a heavy cloak, soaking wet from the rain. The prince happened to be walking past, but when he heard the voice of the young woman, he stopped in his tracks. She explained to the servant, "My driver got lost in the rain, and we saw the light from your castle. Would you be kind enough to provide us shelter for the night?" She had the voice of an angel, and the prince knew immediately that this must be his princess. He quickly ran up and excused the servant. "Of course you are welcome to stay, good lady," he said, bowing respectfully. Allow me to take your coat." When she pulled the hood off her head, the prince thought that she was the most beautiful woman he had ever seen in his life. "Thank you so much, kind sir." The prince was so excited he ran to go tell his mother what had happened. But right after he told her the story, she scoffed. "My dear son, she is no princess," she said. "What kind of a princess goes out in the rain knocking on doors in the middle of the night? Shouldn't she have a servant for that?" She peeked out into the hall to get a look at the girl and was appalled to see her with dripping wet hair and a moody dress. "You see, she is no more than a common peasant. But mother," argued the prince, "look at how she walks. I've never seen anything more graceful." The queen could see that her son had already fallen for the girl. So she quickly devised a plan to get rid of her. "All right, then if you don't believe me, we will put her to a test. Tonight we will dress her bed with 10 of the softest, fluffiest, most luxurious feather mattresses in the castle. Then under the 10 mattresses, we will place a single uncooked pea. If this pea disturbs her sleep, then we will know only a real princess would be delicate and refined enough to feel the pea." The prince didn't think that anybody would be able to feel the pea, but he also knew that his mother knew best. Besides, he thought, he didn't want to marry anything less than a real princess. So the queen ordered her servants to gather the best mattresses they could find and bring them to the guest tower. Then she took a single pea and put it right in the middle of the bed and had the servants stack all the mattresses on top. Then the prince escorted the guest to her room, where she needed a ladder to get to bed. In the morning, the prince went to the dining hall and peeked inside to get a look at his love. She looked terrible. She had dark circles under her eyes and was sipping a large cup of tea. "I'm so tired," the princess told the servant. "Please do not tell the prince, but that bed is awful. I felt like there was a brick inside it. I didn't sleep a wink all night. I'm so tired." The prince rushed over to her side and knelt before her. Oh, блядь. You're a true princess, aren't you? Please marry me and live here, and I will get you any mattress you need. Choose. The princess looked shocked, but then smiled and said, "Yes, I will marry you, as long as I don't have to sleep on that bed ever again." The next day, after the princess got a good night's sleep without a pea to disturb her, the princess and princess were married, and they lived happily ever after. Yeah, if I was some Western guy, I would cry, but I don't cry. Okay, thank you very much. Hope someone will need my accent. And goodbye, subscribe, and see you later. That night, during a terrible thunderstorm, that the prince thought that she was... Блять.